So for years, many on the right, Donald Trump included, have been putting up these conspiracy theories, and Trump liked to call it Obamagate, right? A lot of people have been talking about the deep state, Obamagate. I want to play you a little bit of audio. It was Donald Trump back in May, who was asked by a reporter about Obamagate. At that time, he didn't seem to know exactly what it was. Have a listen to this.
Obamagate. It's been going on for a long time. It's been going on from before I even got elected. And it's a disgrace that it happened. And if you look at what's gone on, and if you look at now all of this information that's being released, and from what I understand, that's only the beginning. Some terrible things happened, and it should never be allowed to happen in our country again. And you'll be seeing what's going on over the coming weeks. But I wish you'd write honestly about it. But unfortunately, you choose not to do so. Yeah, John, please.
Crime. What is the crime exactly that you're accusing him of?
You know what the crime is. The crime is very obvious to everybody. All you have to do is read the newspapers, except yours.
Mr. President, what's the crime? Well, you know what the crime is. Just read the newspapers.
Except yours.
Yeah, exactly. Except yours. He had no idea what he was talking about. So also in May, it was Donald Trump who attacked Joe Biden after it was revealed that he wanted Flynn's name unmasked. Have a listen to this.
They weren't after General Flynn. They wanted him to lie about me, make up a story. And with few exceptions, nobody did that. There were many people. I watched KT McFarland the other day. I watched where she was knock, knock, FBI, you know, the FBI, okay? This was all Obama. This was all Biden. These people were corrupt. The whole thing was corrupt, and we caught them.
We caught
knock, knock, FBI.
Knock, knock, FBI. We caught them. Well, guess who the person was that was in charge of this investigation? Guess who's the lead man? Some would call him Donald Trump's personal attorney. That's right. I'm talking about, of course, the Attorney General, William Barr. Well, reports just came out that Attorney General Barr's investigation into Flynn's unmasking ended with no criminal charges or a public report. That's right. That means Attorney General Barr is not releasing the report publicly. Well, I'll get to that in a minute.
But that's totally different from Obamagate, Brian.
You're
confusing the Durham report with the unmasking of General Flynn. They're two totally different things.
Okay. Well, I'll explain why I disagree with you in a second.
Well, I mean,
but the development is a massive blow, of course, to President Donald Trump.
No, it's not.
I believe it is, because Donald Trump has argued for months that the Obama administration officials targeted Flynn as a part of the Russia investigation in an effort to undermine Trump before he took office. This is something that we've heard for years from Donald Trump and certain members of his administration. What is unmasking, if you're unaware what that is? It refers to the practice of revealing the identity of a U.S. person whose name is incidentally collected in intelligence reports monitoring the communication of foreign agents. So the conspiracy theory picked up some steam back in May. We played some of that audio when Richard Grenell, then the acting director of national intelligence, declassified a list of Obama administration officials who made unmasking requests that included Flynn's name between November 30th of 2016 and January 12th of 2017. Former Vice President Joe Biden, now the Democratic nominee, of course, was among the names on that list. So Trump and his allies seized on the development and said it showed that Biden and others improperly unmasked the former national security advisor's identity. But this Washington Post report earlier in May debunked that allegation when it revealed that Flynn's name was never masked in the first place. So what you've heard from Donald Trump for years in regards to the alleged unmasking of Flynn and Obama being a part of it and Biden being a part of it.
Knock, knock, FBI.
Yeah, knock, knock, FBI. Well, again, I'll say it one more time. Attorney General Barr, the investigation into the unmasking has ended without any criminal charges, and Attorney General Barr has decided not to release the public report. Why is he not? Yeah, there you go. I like that. A little Price is Right action there. Why is he not releasing the public report? Because he doesn't want you to see it, because it'll make Donald Trump look bad. Now, this isn't the first time that Donald Trump has promoted baseless conspiracy theories. I could name you a long laundry list, but I'll give you one just from this week, JD. I want you to hear this because this is pretty daunting. This week, President Donald Trump promoted a baseless conspiracy theory This happened yesterday, actually, alleging that the Obama administration covered up a plot to stage Osama bin Laden's death. It is a wild accusation that was pushed on Twitter accounts linked to the QAnon conspiracy theory. Trump retweeted this article from an account with a history of promoting the QAnon conspiracy theory, alleging Biden and Obama may have had SEAL Team 6 killed and that bin Laden may still be alive. The conspiracy theory also alleged that Obama had been bin Laden's body double that was killed. So late Tuesday night, Trump retweeted this conspiracy theory, claims Hillary Clinton and Biden colluded with Iran to arrange for bin Laden to be transferred to Pakistan for Obama's trophy kill right before his election. Re-election, I should say. The Biden campaign hit back at Trump for promoting the conspiracy theory, calling the president unhinged, which I would agree. And then there's Robert O'Neill. Do you remember who this man is? This is the former Navy SEAL who, on many accounts, claimed to be the one who actually shot and killed bin Laden.
He made a video on an airplane about a month and a half ago.
Yeah, that has nothing to do with this, but yes. It was something about not wearing a mask, but that has nothing to do. So he lashed out at the president on Twitter for pushing the conspiracy theory. It was not a body double, O'Neill said, and he went on. So I would imagine, JD, you would hopefully agree with me on this one, that is obviously a conspiracy theory that is debunked and there's no evidence.
Well, why are we talking about this? And we should be talking about the fact that Hunter Biden, emails from Hunter Biden to Burisma and the Ukrainian government, where Joe Biden was actively involved in that entire situation, that was just revealed today, 2 or 3 hours ago, and that was actually in the New York Times, which is about as left-wing as you can find.
Okay,
why are we talking about these?
So we can talk about
very, very minor, this very, very minor thing. And also, why is Michael Flynn? Why is Michael Flynn not in jail? Why did his case get dismissed?
By the way, it's New York Post, not the Times.
No, actually, the Times. Haberman did the exact same thing.
Okay, well, I'm just telling you what I've seen. But let me answer your question.
Facebook is actually preventing that particular piece of information from being spread on their social media outlets.
Okay, so let me just answer
which is the definition of election interference, by the way.
Okay, so let me answer.
I hope under article or section 230 they actually become a publisher like they should be.
Well, if you're so interested in election interference, then maybe the president should be a little bit more interested in what Russia did in 2016 and what Russia is going to be doing right now. But anyway, let's get back to
it's actually the exact opposite.
Okay, so let's keep in mind
that Vladimir Putin last week said that that Biden's economical philosophy aligns with his more than Trump's does.
Want Biden to win. Okay.
That's what Putin said last week, Brian.
Well, I guess that means that Russia's not interfering to try to get Trump elected. I agree. Okay, so let me answer your question first.
And you're also mixing up the Flynn unmasking with the Durham report and what Obamagate actually is.
Okay.
And what happened with this whole Russian
trying
idea
to answer your question.
Is Jake Sullivan, one of Hillary Clinton's staffers, created this idea to distract the general public from her emails. And by the way, Pompeo has those emails. They will be released before the election. That's been announced. But to distract from the emails by saying that Donald Trump is this Russian asset. Hillary Clinton ran with that during the debate, called him a puppet for Putin, called him, said he owed all this money to Russia. By the way, there's no proof of that whatsoever. And then it led into...
So who does he owe money to then?
Banks? Probably banks worldwide.
Knock, FBI.
Do you know he owes
money to the banks?
It's a Trump organization for properties, for assets that
which
they
have. Which is under investigation.
Everything's under investigation.
No,
Brian,
I'm not under investigation. No, I'm not under investigation. You're not under investigation.
You're not important enough
to be under
investigation.
Is Joe Biden under investigation by the FBI?
His son's computer with emails just showed up today, so I think the answer to that is yes.
You think? My knowledge, Joe Biden is not under investigation by the FBI.
If Joe Biden's son's laptop just showed up and the FBI produced it as evidence, that would lead me to believe, well, that's what happened, but that would lead me to believe that Joe Biden's son is or was at some point under investigation by the FBI.
Which you don't know. All right. So let me try
then how would they get his laptop, Brian?
Okay, so let me respond to the three or four rhetorical questions that you brought up.
But I'm not finished, though.
Okay, so I want to answer them now because we don't have time.
By the way,
the Senate report did conclude that Biden did not do anything illegal, so I just wanted to add that into what you're saying because that's kind of important, JD.
What's Senate report for what?
He didn't do anything wrong. He didn't break the law.
For what?
He might have done things allegedly that, you know, he might have done things that you might not find the right thing to do as a politician.
This laptop with these emails just showed up like 3 hours ago, Brian. So I doubt there's
the Republican Senate.
I doubt there's been a Senate report already.
Okay,
on
so
that.
I'm getting, but, I'm getting, I'm answering I'm that. Not, you not, asked me a question.
Well, no, I'm not finished.
The Republican,
I'm still not
okay,
finished.
Give
yet,
me 10
Brian.
Seconds this to whole, answer your question. No, can whole, I have 10 seconds?
This whole just, idea, you okay. Stop trying to derail me. This
I'm
whole,
not derailing you. I'm giving you facts. You don't no, have the
actually,
facts.
Actually, you are.
The Republican Senate report said that Biden didn't break the law.
Can you please stop interrupting me, Brian?
Well, we have to take a break.
I understand I'm making Joe Biden look bad, and you don't like that on our show.
No, you're not. You're making yourself look bad.
I actually am.
You're making yourself look bad. You're defending Donald Trump again when you can't.
What do you mean when I can't? But what happened was Jake Sullivan, a staffer of Hillary Clinton, created this idea that Donald Trump was widely connected to Russia. This led to the Mueller report, which was totally baseless, which also led to the Vindman call, or to the Vindman whistleblower.
Did you hear what I just
which
said?
Led to the Ukrainian
call. The Republican
call,
Senate
which,
report which said
led,
he didn't break the
which
law.
Which led to the
You're
impeachment.
You're ignoring me.
And the impeachment actually went through. It was from January, I think, 1st. To February 5th. Mm-hmm. On the 30th of January, Donald Trump shut down travel to China. Let's keep in mind. Well,
what are you talking about?
What I'm
right
saying
now?
Is all of this, has gone on for Donald Trump's entire time
so
as president of the United States into the COVID-19 crisis.
Okay.
Yet he is blamed for every single thing. It's crazy to me that right. Donald Trump is supposed
yeah,
to.
He's such a victim.
While he's being impeached, he is supposed to shut down the best economy in the world.
Okay.
While there's,
you're all well, over
there's
the
three
place.
Or four cases in the entire United States based on misinformation.
Are you done now? Because we got to take a break.
WHO in China. Brian,
we got
to
take a break.
I'm just saying it's crazy to me.
I'm just saying we got to take a break.
How Donald Trump can be held accountable for this.
It's crazy.
But Joe Biden cannot.
It's
crazy. And it's starting to turn out that Donald Trump is the one that actually was not doing anything, and Joe Biden was. It's constant projection.
We got to take a break
from the left.
We got to take a break.
To stop.
We got to take a break. You have to stop because.